God is in the family, love is always there.
When God is in the family, we're closer together.
When God is in the family, blessings are from everywhere.
When God is in the family, everything is there. So let Him now come in, my friend. Through your door is always knocking. He brings with Him His gift for us, and the gift is life eternal.
When God is in the family, love is always there. God is in the family, we're closer together. When God is in the family, blessings are found everywhere. When God is in the family, everything is there. When God is in the family,
welcome back again to our Hope for Today's Family series.
How are you and your family?
I pray that they're doing very well, because tonight we will listen again to another interesting topic. We will have Pastor Oliver and Belge Isler, one of our district pastors in Northern Capiz area, as they share about marriage as God intended it to be, and the need to focus actually on what we can give rather than what you can get.
They would like also to share to us an important metaphor that will help us easily visualize how you can get the most out of marriage by investing in your marriage life every day.
So I hope that this metaphor will be remembered by us in order for us to really see how marriage should be according to what God intended it to be. Let's talk about the family marriage God's way. But just before that, we will have our prayer.
Let us pray. Our gracious, kind, loving Heavenly Father, we praise you and we thank you for giving us an example how to have a happy family. Thank you, dear Lord, that your presence will be felt by each one of us tonight who will be listening to our topic tonight about the family, about the marriage life. Thank you, dear Lord, that your Holy Spirit will be with each of us tonight who will be listening. Thank you for being with our speaker, Mom Bell and Pastor Oliver. Thank you for using them. Thank you so much for the Holy Spirit that will inspire each family who will be listening tonight. This all we ask. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray.
Amen.
Today we will have this Teaching Kitchen episode, and I am Dr. Michelle Palma. Together with me is my assistant, Margaret. Today we will be learning some of the recipes that we will teach you. This is repurposing food. Again, when we mean repurposing food is that using your food as medicine. The next recipe that we will make here is a very simple sweet potato wrap. So we have a lot of variations in serving your salads, remember? So sometimes if you eat salads three times in a day, it's really necessary to have some strategy and to be artistic enough on how to use those ingredients and how to feed them to your family. So this is one very simple way to tweak some of those recipes. So you just have to have all the salad ingredients you have and put them in a wrap. But where do you get your wrap? Usually we buy it from the department stores or from the grocery store, right? So all of those has, of course, they have preservatives, because just to have a long shelf life. But again, you can make your own wrap in the house. just having two ingredients, and what we have here is any type of sweet potatoes, and then you have your oatmeal flour. Okay, so it's just like the oatmeal flour that we used earlier. Now, if you don't have oatmeal in the house, then you can use any types of flour that has in, that you have in your pantry. Okay, so basically we just need equal portion of your sweet potatoes and an equal portion of your oatmeal flour. Alright, so we just have to put our sweet potato here and then we just have to mash it. Now remember that the sweet potato should be boiled so that we can reach a soft consistency as much as possible. It has to be soft and not dry. Alright, so you just have to mash the sweet potato first before you add your flour or your oatmeal flour. You're eating this kind of wrap, Margaret, right? So here, this is just ready. And then we add same proportion of your oatmeal flour. And then if you think you need some water to be added, then you can add some water. All right, and then the next thing that we're gonna do here is to knead the sweet potato mixed with our oatmeal flour. Okay, so I think we just reached the right consistency and this is ready as a dough. All right, so in this stage, we need our hands here. Okay, you just have to make a dough out of it. Alright, so we already have the dough here. You just have to make a good consistency of your dough. And then, of course, we will be needing your board. And, of course, your roller. And we will be also needing a portion of your oatmeal flour. Because we have to make a shape of a wrap. So I'm only making one wrap here. And we need the roller. So it's just plain and simple. We don't add any salt, we don't add any sugar, no preservative at all. Just two ingredients. No oil at all. So again, like I said earlier, if you think your sweet potato is a bit dry, then you have to use water. But in this case, it's just okay. And so as you can see, we didn't add any water. So be careful not to add too much of a flour. Otherwise, your wrap will be hard, you know, when you cook them. So we want it soft as well. Okay, so here, just about 1 to 2 millimeters thin, and then we have to throw it in the pan and just cook it right there, no oil at all. So when we put it in the pan, just we just have to make sure that we have to flip it every 1 to 2 minutes. So here, you can choose to use your nonstick pan or any stainless pan will also do. Okay, so this is the way you cook your wrap in a low temperature. Most probably in about 1 to 2 minutes, you will be flipping it over. And then in about 5 minutes, you will be done. Okay, so but if you want to make a potato chips out of the same ingredients, then you can chop this into whatever forms you want and then put them on the pan and then just cook them the same way But this should be longer, all right? So until you reach the consistency and the crispiness that you want. Okay, so we have here finished products. So we have here the sweet potato wrap, and then we also have the sweet potato chips. Okay, so this time we will assemble our salad wrap. So we have our sweet potato wrap already ready here. So earlier we made our vegan mayo, if you remember. And so another ingredients that we need here are diced tomatoes and then diced onions. And then we will be needing our seaweeds here and then our lettuce and any leftover viand you have in the house. So this one I have here, this is vegan affrittata. So this is made of gluten, but you can also use the banana blossom patty that we had earlier. You just have to chop it into small pieces so that we can add this into our salad wrap. Okay, so we just have to assemble. We have here our sweet potato wrap, and then we just have to put here our mayo, just enough. Okay, so just spread it around. Okay, and then we just have to add our tomatoes and then our onions. So for kids, they don't really like onions, so you can skip them. And then we just have to add our seaweeds here. So this will add up umami taste in your wrap. And then of course, we have to put our leftover, any vegan viand that you have. So if you have tofu, then you can use tofu. If you have your, like the banana blossom patty earlier, we can use them as well. And then lastly, we can put our lettuce over. So you just tear the lettuce right size, and then we just have to wrap it. There you go. We have our salad wrap.
isa ka malipayon nga pagpanamyaw sa tanan-tanan nga mga nagapamati kag sa nagatan-aw no, sa aton nga program sa sining bulan kag ayan man sa sining semana, isa ka pagpanamyaw nga buot namon ipaabot sa mga pinalangga namon nga makauturan ka makabyanan sa mga nasari-sari nga parte sang palangumhan sang amon union no, sa amon nga union kag sa mga pipila ka mga konferensya nga nangin kaupod naton upo diri sa West Visayan Conference. Isa gid ka oportunidad kag pagpasalamat namon nga mangin kaupod kamo sa sining isa ka programa sa pag-enlighten, sa paghatag sang dalan kag kadalag-an sa pagkabuhi bilang mag-asawa. So ang tigulo sang aton nga pag-istoryahan sa sining ation, marriage God's way. So nagakahulugan makauturan nga ang pag-asawahay isa ka modelo nga ginhatag kag gintugyan sang Dios sa aton sining kagabihon. Well,
oh, we would like to greet no sa aton mga kauturan sa West Visayan Conference kag sa aton mga kaigsuunan man sa Central Visayan Conference kag sa iban pa nga mga konferensya sa nasakop sa Central Philippine Union Conference. Welcome gid sa aton nga programa. Kag sa sining gabi, Pastor, amo na nga aton nga topiko, marriage God's way. Ano gid bala ang model nung marriage para sa Ginoo? Tonight mabalaan naton kung ano gid ayhan ang tuod digali nga modelo sa pag-asawahay, no? So marriage God's way.
So may mga nasari-sari nga pagpakilala, ang pag-introduce sa aton na hanungod sa ginatawag naton nga pag-asawahay. There are those nga nagasiling marriage is the only war where you get to sleep with the enemy. So usually mambel kalabanan sa aton nga nahibaluan, mga pinalangga naton nga makauturan nga kaaway mabudlay gyud nga tuparan sa pagtulog no, labi na gyud kon ara kamo at war kamo. But may ara isa ka lambalanon sang isa ka indi kilala nga nagasiling nga ang pag-asawahay kon kaisa away ini siya nga nagatulog ikaw pud sa imong kaaway. So sometimes unique. What are those? Ano pa gid
ang iban? Ang iban, nagahambal sila Pastor, ang iban, ang definition sa marriage is, it is an alliance entered into by a man who can sleep with the window shut and a woman who can sleep with the window open. That's according to George Bernard. Meaning, ang pag-asawahay, it's a union of two different individuals. Mm-hmm. Diba? Kulis, ang gusto sang bana, amuni ang gusto sang asawa, opposite. Yeah, diba? But here comes marriage. It's a combination of two different persons. Mm-hmm. Man. Ang bana ni Pastor ni George Bernard.
Kaga two different kwan man, mga views, mga likes and dislikes, right? Okay, sa atin niya kapit.
Which is very, ano, very realistic, diba? Talagsa ka lang gitkakita ya nga nag-marry, nga pari-pariho gin sila tanang-tanang na ways, diba? Usually, kahabal pa nila nga ni Pastor, opposite attracts.
Yeah.
Diba? But usually, gid, kisa, ang ara sa marriage, two different individuals. Mm-hmm. Even kita.
Uh-huh.
We have different likes, we have different dislikes.
But, kay balan mo, Ma'am Bella, may ginatawag kita nga, hambal pa ganin nila, nagkita ay kita nga tigulang na. Nagkalain-lain kita sa family background, nagkalain-lain kita sa pagpatubo, paano kita
gin. We are brought up in different ways. And we have also our different home cultures and traditions. Iba, whether we like it or not, mga kauturan, mga listeners, iba-iba kita eh. Paano kita gin brought up, anong environment kita. And when it comes to marriage, halin ka mo both sa different backgrounds, pag abot sa marriage, you have to fit in. Though we have to meet at the center. So, amo ni hambali George Bernard, na marriage is an alliance entered into by a man. Now, different sila sang views. Ano pagid ang hambal?
Sili ni Chris Rock, only married people can understand how you can be miserable and happy at the same time. Nagabot sili ngon nga ang pagpangabuhi abi sang pagtiayo magtiayo no kun mag-asawa makauturan they are the one no, sila ang nagahatag actually mambel sang control na ara sa ilang yabi sang happiness kagun kaisa sa mga miserable nga klase man sa pagpangabuhi. So it is in their own control, no, kung paano nila ginpatigayon, paano nila ginmanage ang pag-asawahay nga mag-succeed ini o kung ma-fail, mm-hmm, depending sa ilang ginhimo.
So, as akon pastor, ang humble ni Chris Rama, only married people can understand how can you be miserable and at the same time, happy, because ang marriage, mga kauturan, mga listeners, ang marriage nato niya, it's a mixture of happy moments and sad moments. Hindi man, it's impossible, it's really impossible to say nga nag-marry ka mo and then all the rest of your lives are happy moments lang. Diba? May alagi na ups and downs. And this is the point ni Chris Rock, nga ang marriage, it's a mixture of ups and downs.
Yeah.
Na, amo na yung definition sa marriage. Now, pastor, may nakita ko nga man namin nga explanation man on marriage. Humble day, in Genesis 2, verse 24, humble that this is why a man leaves his father and mother and becomes attached to his wife and they become one flesh. Mm-hmm. According to the one who made this, an anonymous person, humble niya, marriage is defined as, when you say this is why a man, marriage, when you say marriage, it must be mature. Diba? Mature. Mahamba ka ang man. Maturity. And leaves, that's transition. His father and mother, that's a model of a complete family. Uh-huh. And becomes attached. When you say attached, it means here a comes new. A new family. You're making a new family. To his wife, it means a compliment. Someone you can share your sadness with. Someone who will complete you. Diba? And they become, that's a process of learning, of friendship and trust, and one flesh. That means when it comes to marriage, there's a deep intimacy between two people. So isn't that amazing? Na may explanation on marriage.
So in short, there are stages,
mm-mm,
okay? There are timings,
mm-mm,
there are learnings, and Mambel, most of all, there is what we call foundation, no? Sa ang ginatawag natin nga pagkuan, no? Pag-asawahay.
It does not come like immediately lang bala nga, nag-exist na dayon. It takes time. It has a process.
Amo na ganing hambal nila nga, sila nila, marriage is not a word. It's a sentence. Mm-hmm. Nila.
It's a life sentence.
It's a life sentence. Okay? So, actually, no, ining mambel ang ginatawag natin bala kung kaisa nga pag-asawahay, mangin dokwan siya bala, no? No, mangin type bala sa kabuo isang tao, maabot sa kabuo isang tao nga ginalantaw mo, what will happen next? Mm-hmm. What will happen next? You know, but, of course, nakaibalo kita nga ang mga choices nga ginahimo nato nang bala ganin nila Mambel, you are free to choose but you're not free of the consequences. So meaning, whatever you do today, you know nga in later times may ara ka gid nga makuha ang result sa mga decisions nga ginimo. So you have to start maturely and you have to face all transitions, you have to have that good model, no? Modelo. And you have to recognize also sa ginatawag natin nga new family na compliment, no? Kung ara ka na upod sa imong asawa, and learning sa the process sa pag-asawahay to have that
time.
Deep intimacy between sa duha ka tawo.
Usually, to be pastor, especially sa mga dalaga, mm-hmm, when we say marriage, ako ha, when we say marriage, at first we tend to look at the side ba lang, oh, wedding gown, mm-hmm, sa, di ba?
Excited sa wedding gown.
Excited gown, di ba? When we were yet singles, di ba? Oh, wedding gowns, prenups, di ba? Choosing your flower girls, choosing your groomsmen, di ba? No? You're very excited for that event.
Mm-hmm.
No, kay para sa imo, the first step of marriage, no, ang forefront na sa marriage, it's the wedding. But actually, marriage, you will experience marriage right after that wedding.
Mm-hmm.
Mahambag nila, marriage is an eye-opener.
No. Kaya mali lang ko naman, Ben, when you think that love is blind, then marriage is an eye-opener. Oh, because reality exists, yeah, after sang wedding.
Kapag reality hits you, dira na niyo mabalan, ang galit niya ang marriage.
Whether they like it or not, masugot magkita kahit sa hindi mga pinalangga ang makautan. There are young people who will often ask us, namumangkot sila, Pastor, how to know somebody? How to know deeply somebody deeply? Okay? Paano mo gid makilala ang isang kababae? Manang ang permanente ko na ginasabat sa ilang mabel, pangasaw, abla, kay kilala mo gid eh. Oh. Because
yes,
there are hidden secrets during sa mga
courtship
courtship
that you won't really know.
Hmm. that mahibalan mo lang mm-hmm. kung nasa bahay na.
Siyempre, the man must behave in a really attractive manner. Diba?
Mabakita na natin in the last part sa ato yung presentation.
Okay. So, ari pagid na isa. And we will know kay Ellen White, ano yung pastor na definition sa marriage?
Nambal niya, sila niya, it was designed to be a blessing to mankind. No? It is a blessing wherever the marriage covenant is entered intelligently in the fear of God and with due consideration for its responsibilities.
It's a blessing. Blessing. But, wherever, mayara condition, Pastor, if, wherever, the marriage covenant is entered intelligently in the fear of God and with due consideration of its responsibilities. Meaning, if you enter marriage unintelligently, without the fear of the Lord, na without considering responsibilities, so marriage will become a curse.
Yes. Amo nang iya kabaliktaran, ma'am. Sometimes abi no, wala lang gid naton ginapanghuna-huna, wala naton ginatan-aw, kaya mo tagani marriage God's way. Mm-hmm. Amot silingon ang tinutuyo sini, ang sentro gid sini mga pinalangga namon nga mga kauturan, ka mga kaabyanan, nga ang sentro sa pag-asawahay actually among Dios.
Mm-hmm.
So kung hindi naton pag-uyupod ang Dios, kay para sa ako nabi, this is our consideration, no? Wise consideration naton nga ang pag-asawahay maging successful lamang luwas kun butang nato, no, Ma'am Bel? Luwas lang kun wala nato ging kilala ang Dios, no, makabato ni kita sa mga failures, may mga pagsisisi sa ulihi kung wala kita preparation. So in short, intelligent, we must be intelligent, we must have that wisdom, no, meaning ginplano naton, ginas naton ang Ginoo, we talk about it and we figure it out and then we are ready for it. Ready, hindi kita ready, that's why
so, yung mga curse.
Yes.
Okay. And we will tackle more. Mm-hmm. We will tackle more. According to Scott Lapierre, he is a marriage counselor, no, very well-known marriage counselor in the US. According to him, and of all the definition mga kauturan, mga among mga viewers, this idea is like it's heavy for me. Any idea, it hits me. Hambal dito, your marriage reflects your relationship with Christ. Ang imo kuno nga marriage, kon ano ang imong status imo marriage, it reflects your relationship with Christ. Mm-hmm. Man ka bug-at nga statement, Pastor, no? And Ellen White supports that. Ano hambal Ellen White?
Sa Adventist home, sinya Christ honored marriage relation by making it a symbol of union between him and his redeemed ones. So in short, Mabel, amo na gani, no, kung balik ko natin gamay mga pinalangga natin yung mga kauturan yung book of Genesis, there are two things only nga gingimo sa Dios nga balaan, no, duha lang gid kabutang, it's about Sabbath and marriage. So in short, Mabel,
sacred.
Ang
very
marriage
sacred
is something for God, no, amo na gani ginambal niya diri, it is a representation of him, no, representation niya sang aton Dios, that ginapakilala niya nga kita iya mga gin redeem, no.
So meaning, Pastor, it has a direct connection when you say do not be unequally yoked with a believer, because diba when you marry, your marriage would tell us your personal connection with the Lord. So
yes,
how can you create that personal connection with the Lord
if you're
how can you show your marriage or how can you show others that you have a personal connection with the Lord
if you're with
when you marry someone who don't have that connection
sa Ginoo? That's why gani, Ma'am Bel, no, this is very something nga tani mahangpan sa aton mga viewers, sa aton mga nga mga matagpalamati kay kuani siya, Ma'am Bel, do kumbaga bala ang connection naton sa Ginoo. Amo na gani ang hambal ni Apostle Paul nga bisan si Jesus, no, ginamba niya na nga paano bala magkasugot ang duha, paano sila maglakat kung wala sila nagkasugot nga duha. So in short, how could we have that intimate relationship sa Ginoo kung kita mismo nga duha hindi insakto ang aton nga mga prinsipyo sa aton nga kabuhi? So kag isa pa, Ma'am Bel, amo ni when your relationship in Christ, no, between sa aton kay of course si Christ, ginapakilala niya ang iyang na self as groom and the church is a bride. Diba? Kita among bride, no? Kita nga mga believers among bride, and si Jesus among groom. We are the representative. Ang aton nga panimalay is a model. Ang pag-asawa, igali naton model. So, may gitudlo ba lang si Kristo nga ang iya nga church, kag ang iya kag siya, si Christ kag ang church, pwede lang ba lang nga magkabuhi sila nga mabalaton nga hindi bala mambel kwan, hindi bala totally opposite, mabal kita nga totally opposite sila. Pwede lang bala nga si Christ i-claim niya ang iya nga church nga si Christ siya righteous, tapos may church siya nga unrighteous, could it be possible? So ironic. Same likewise, same likewise sa pag-asawahay. It's impossible really, okay?
And also, hambal ganyan ni William Elaine Oliver sa ilang book na Hope for Today's Feminist. Hambal nila, the more we read, this also supported the claim, Miss Scott Kaina, na our marriage would tell us how deep our relationship with the Lord. Hambal ni William Elaine Oliver, the more we read the word of God ourselves and with our spouse, the more we will be in tune with what God wants for us and for our families.
By the way, Ma'am Ben, malipat ako, no? Sorry to say, no? Basi kung na-misinterpret kita sa mga kauturan naton nga medyo may ara sila, nag-start lang ilang relationship, nag-asawahay sila ng isa,
hindi
Adventist, or ang isa Adventist, ang isa believer, ang isa hindi believer. No, mga kauturan, we're speaking here more about sa relationship naton sa Ginoo. I know, nga sa iban nga hindi pareho ang aton faith, you have that struggle. Kay many times kita, Ma'am Bel, maka-encounter kita bisan sa district, maka-encounter kita sa nasari-sari nga mga tao nga mag-share sa ilang problema sa ilang spouse. It's because ang ilang partner hindi believer, and hopefully nga sa mga partner man nga hindi believer this time, it is now your turn to discover and to show them
nga ikaw may ara ka Ginoo. Iba ang basang Bible. Kung may abana ka nga daw nga hindi tumuluo, hindi siya pagbulagi. Kung nasawa mo na bala, hindi siya bulagi, because, di ba, ang bada naging binmake naman sa Ginoo nga holy, bangod sa imo, nga ikaw believer ka. So, imo da nga himuon, the best thing there is that to show your husband or to show your unbelieving wife nga the Lord is with you and you believe on God and you follow the Lord. And who knows? Who knows?
That's why ang balya, the more we read the Word of God ourselves and with our spouse, the more we will be in tune with God wants for us and for our family. So in short, Ma'am Bel, this is ang ginatawag nato ni siya nga unity, no? Nga mga unity. It's not about me. Hindi lang about sa ako that I have to read the Bible, nga ako lang yung ma-worship. Struggles gini Ma'am Bel sa sulod sa family, nga kung kaisa pareho pa gani ka mo faith, pareho pa ka mga believer, kung kaisa ang nag-worship lang ang wife, ang bana hindi, ang isa ya Bible reader. And sometimes we tend to kwan man, no, ma-compromise man naton kay inablang basa kada kay mabasa man ko di. Do hindi naton bala ma-experiencean ang ginatawag naton nga supposedly ang worship sa sulod sa panimalay mga kauturan. It's not only about, yes, of course, no? Ang aton faith, it's about me and God, no? Duha lang gid kami, no? Duha lang kita. Hindi ko pwede ma-credit ang akon nga righteousness sa akon asawa, kung akon asawa hindi sila yung faithful. Pero pag-abot sa ginatawag nato, Ma'am Bel, pag-asawahay, because you are already one, no? Iba na naton. Nga may ara na ka mga unity, ginisa ka mo sa Diyos. So it doesn't mean nga, ako iya, nag-alagad sa Ginoo, ikaw hindi. That's why ang banya, if the more we read the Word of God ourselves and with
our spouse, the more we will be in tune.
Yeah. So, so in short, Ma'am Bel, pwede nga maging successful ang isa, pero ang isa mabilin. Pwede nga maging burden mo siya, since nga ikaw may naming relationship sa Ginoo, pero siya wala. So, it should be a partnership. Okay? Partnership ang pagkilala sa Ginoo.
According to Willie and Elaine Oliver, ma-compare ko na nato ang marriage, Pastor, through an emotional bank.
Dawal kan siya.
Emotional bank. Because, di ba, when we have a bank account, the more we deposit, the more nga mag-increase ang aton nga interest. Di ba? And the more kita nga mag-withdraw, the more mag-mubo aton nga interest. Or at times, we lose interest. Mamuna, pareho man ko no sa marriage, Pastor. When we deposit keeping promises, when we deposit kind words, when we deposit understanding, when we deposit loyalty, when we deposit listening, even when you don't like to listen at all, irritate ka na, but you still listen. And say, I'm sorry. You deposit the attitude to say, I'm sorry, biska hindi ikaw ang nakasala. And when you deposit set clear expectations. Mm-hmm. Amo bala nga traits? Mm-hmm. When you deposit that, the interest goes higher and higher. Your interest sa imo partner, sa imo mga spouse, goes higher and higher. Pero when you withdraw, break promises, you break promises, you keep to yourself secrets, na wala nang kabalong imo mga spouse, you gossip and break confidences, you don't listen, you are arrogant, you are proud, hindi ka gina pa perde, ikaw gina ang daog, and you set false expectations, you are like withdrawing from the emotional bank, and you eventually lose interest.
So, but silingon si Namambel, when you do deposit, hindi ba na ito nga deposit, hala ka lang gikabutang,
give.
Amo na ngambal nga, hambal pa ganyan nila, relationship, ang gugma is a matter of give and take. Now, amo na ngambal, pag isang isa ka lang, anong mahatag ko sa imo, kung wala ako? So, paano ka mag-withdraw sa akon?
Kung wala.
Paano ko ikaw hatagan sang interest?
Oo.
Kung wala ka nag-deposit sa akon. So,
paano ka-withdraw kung wala ka kwarta?
So ang tendencies actually you're not looking for withdrawals, no? Hindi enough magsigig ka lang ka deposit, hala ka butang deposit, tapos sige ka man withdraw. Nga nag-deposit ka because you're looking for
interest.
Hindi nga hala ka lang to ka nag-deposit ka lang tapos gina-withdraw mo man. So in short, maabot ang time ngang imo interest madula again. Mm-hmm. So tama ina, no? Paano? Ang pag-asawahay, ang tagipusuan sa aton nga mga partner, dira kita nagabutang.
Emotional.
And kung ginapasakita natin ini, nag-withdraw.
And eventually, you lose interest. Your partner.
Depleted na. Uh-huh. Time will come, mga depleted na mambel ang aton yagin pang butang dito until mag-ano, why na interest. Now, Willie and Elaine Oliver added, when you are kind to your spouse, you are making deposits in their emotional bank account.
Mm-hmm.
Kindness is an act of kindness. No? Kindness, mambel, here is mambal naton mambel nga daw kakwan siya daw kabroad siya nga word kay damo-damo ang mga butang ara sa sulod sang kindness, no? The more emotional deposits you make in the emotional bank account of your spouse, the richer your relationship will be. Na the reverse, trying to get more than you give leads to a bankrupt
relationship.
So in short, mambel, hindi ba pwedeng ikaw mag-grow? Hindi ba pwedeng ako mag-grow nga ako lang? Dapat duwa kita. Ano na panawag sinaman kung pag-abot sa ginatawa? Ang imo nga bangko, kung ikaw ang akon nga bangko, I have to deposit sa imo sa mga positive reinforcements. And at the same time, ikaw man niya, agudwa kita mag-grow. Mm-hmm. Okay? So, kung kaisa amo ni ang nagakatabo, one-sided ang
relationship
uh-huh. sa pag-asawahay, Ma'am Ben. There are tendencies. Nga ako iya, ma-feed ako sa imo sa mga positive reinforcements. Tapos siya, ikaw in return niya, wala ka pa abi nag-deposit sa ako, nag-withdraw ka na. Why na?
And tonight, we are going to look into some of the tips, no? To have a godly relationship and within marriage so that we can attain the marriage God's way. Okay, number one, mga kauturan, stop labeling your marriage as dysfunctional.
Mm-hmm.
Dysfunctional, pastor, in a sense nga, daw imo naging butangan nga, this won't work.
Ah, diba? Hindi ka happy. Hindi ka satisfied.
Mahambal, diba, I got to meet some of our brethren nga mahambal, hindi ko naging siya love, yeah, ma'am? Hindi naging, wala naging gunabat siya gan sa iya. And I think our marriage has to end.
Yeah.
Hambal din, the human brain is wired to believe what we tell it. So when we say, hindi ko na siya palangga, hindi, naging kuya na namin yan.
The more you talk, and the more you think.
Amo nang gina na result. Because the human brain is wired to believe what we tell it.
Mm.
If you keep saying your marriage is dysfunctional, you will begin to believe it. Di ba yung tsakto? Tuod,
it will begin to happen. Matabo na lang. Matabo na lang.
Psychologically. And because our relationships with our spouses are a reflection of our relationship with Christ, our marriage problems are actually really only symptoms. Symptoms lang siya. Because the actual problems are in our relationship with Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Daka namin, no?
So, klaro ka tama. Ang problema, natabo lang ina, sintoma ina, effect mga pinalangga, na effect na lang ina, mga pinalangga namon, because bangod sa aton relationship, maybe sa aton spouse, and to God. So, kung kaisa, abig na bala ton, why na ko gana sa relationship naton? Amuni nga, kay damo-damo kita problema. Daw ang ginhimo naton, nga wala nag-work out ang aton relationship because ang aton nga mga problems. But actually, ang problem, galiya mambel, secondary na lang na iya. Ang primary gidya, isang aton nga relationship sa Dios. Okay. So, sa siniya mo na, stop labeling your marriage as dysfunctional because the more you think about it, the more ka nga mag, ang imo nga panghuna-huna, dito na lang permanente.
Matabo gito eh.
Ambal nila. Ang bad pa ganila, you are what you eat.
Mm-hmm.
But this time, you are what you think you are.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? So the more you think, sa isa kabutang, don't work. Mm-hmm. Ang ining relationship, hindi baka survive. Ang ako na asawa, yung imperfect gil saya. Ang ako na asawa mo na, you think negative things about your spouse.
Just point na, Pastor, because when you have this personal relationship with the Lord, you will realize that it's not only your spouse who is imperfect, but you also. Makit-an mo na mo ba makasasala gikay ko Ginoo sa tubangan nimo. And how about your wife? Makasasala man siya. And you will begin to be more understanding with your wife. Kaya ikaw rin itindihan mo man, ikaw ginpasailo ka man sa Ginoo. And you will begin to understand your wife or your spouse. Diba? And when we have this deep relationship with the Lord, ang tudlo sa Ginoo sa aton. Kung ara ang Ginoo sa aton, diba? The fruits of the Spirit, we will be kind. We will be long-suffering. We will be faithful. And amo mo na ipakita na to sa to nga wife, so walay away. Na.
Okay.
Isakto gija. Stop labeling.
Okay.
Now, may isa ka istorya, Pastor.
May isa ka istorya. After Adam stayed out late a few nights, Eve became suspicious. It's a story. Yala ni siya. No? You're running around with another woman. Val ni Eve. Admit it. Bato na, ako agay na, she demanded. Habal ni Adam, what other woman? Adam, shut back, you're it. Anong bot niya silingon si Nakombel? Niya, ikaw ina. Ikaw ina. Nga man.
Nagkasilo si Eve.
Gasilo siya.
Nagkaduda siya. Gabi niya sa special.
No. Kaya late at night na lang.
Gabi na gulang kapuli si Adam.
That night, Adam was fast asleep when he was awakened by Eve poking him in the chest. What are you doing? Hambal ni Kwan, hambal ni Adam, and hambal ni Eve.
Counting
your ribs.
Iisip niya, ribs ba sibla kulang na niya ginatan niya sa Adam? Amo ni siya result. Kung ang sa atong nahuna, we have an end in mind. Kung sa education pa, inang, ano ba fix ka na gidya? Ara na. Nang ano, giniya kong bana, may ara, gini siya babakiya. Himuon pa na lagi tanan-tanan, kaya ara na sa atong nga mind.
So amo na siya ang kwan, amo na siya ang babaga nila. Hindi man kita kay nga ako isa ka suspicious sa aton, probably it happened to us, no? And I want to ano no, gusto ko man ipahangop ini Mambel. The more you think abi sa isa ka kahintangan, kay amo na siya dayon, amo man ang naga-consume sa imo, amo naga-control sa imo,
ginakaon
ganiya. Until such time nga amo na lang gina maging cause ang inyong away.
Kan wala nag-exist, nag-exist na lang.
Exist
siya.
Na lang. Uh-huh. It's because the more you think about it.
Mugid siya maayo kag. Okay. Amo na Philippians 4:8. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, and whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things.
May mga hitabo sa aton kabuhi, Ma'am Bell, nga hindi kita conscious sa aton ginauna-una. Actually, mga kauturan, gamay lang gid katama nga tao sunod sa study ang mahimo nga makakontrol sa ilang brain. Whenever nga alone ka, whenever nga naga-busy ka, whenever nga ara ka sa deep sadness, kag sa tanan-tanan mo, ginabatsyag mo, gamay lang gid nga tao makakontrol sa ilang mind. There are those nga mahimo nila Mambel kontrolo ng ilang nga kabuhi by dwelling on the positive side of the story. No? Pagi sa ano, you have to think hambali ang Apostle Paul sa Philippians chapter 4 verse 8, mga maayong mga butang. You don't have to think about sa mga negative nga mga butang makapalain sa inyo, makapalain sa relationship, o kung makapalain man sa imong spouse, o kung maghatag sa pagdududa, no? Kaya ba niya, what is true, what is pure, what is noble, what is lovely, what is admirable. Supposedly, amon yung atong talingan na una. Because the more we think this, Mambel, the more it happened also to our marriage life. Okay? Sige. So, number two here is pray with all your heart for your marriage and your spouse. Ano nga ba sa Acts chapter 4 verse 32? Basahon ko na yung commentary sa bawah. When the apostles were persecuted, the believers came together and raised their voice to God in one accord. In Acts 4:24, the testimony of the scripture reveals that when this group finished praying together, that they were one heart and one soul. So, anong sikrito mo, Mel?
Prayer.
Prayer.
Kay Pastor, if there's, una bala mga viewers, couples, itong mga married couples, if there's a right time, if there's a right time to pray much harder for our marriage, it would be now. As you see, ang mga new subong, tanan na lang ang mga temptations, tanan na lang gid nga ginhimo sa nyawa, just to destroy marriage, ara na sa aton. Amo na gani nga, if there's a time that we have to pray for our marriage, it would be now. If you have to protect, no matter what happens, we have to protect our marriage. Sa kadamugdan mo subong pastor nga nag-exist, kita mo ang statistics sa divorce, very high. Ang ano pagig subong sa kabit-kabit ng mga issues, very, very high. It's increasing.
Ginambal ko kay naman, Bel. There are two things nga ginhimo sa Dios nga balaan niya, the Garden of Eden. That is Sabbath and marriage. Ang Sabbath, naibalaan din nato, mga pinalangga nato yung mga kauturan. Kung ano ang handong sa Dios nga gubon, ang pagkilala nato sa adlaw ng inyong paway. Same as true with the marriage. Ang pag-asahoy, Ma'am Bel, gusto gid sang yawa nga gubon ini. Now, nga aman, the basic unit sa aton community is the family.
The family.
Kung naguba ang aton nga family,
guba
ang church, guba ang community, guba ang school, guba tanan. That's why, Ma'am Bel, when I was just, I think, an applicant during that time, one of the pastors asked me, sabi niya, anong imo ginatan-aw nga mga innovations kung ikaw ang mangindisig pastor na, if ever mangindisig pastor? Simple lang, mabela ko nga sabat. Siling ko, I think, we don't need innovations. All we need is re-innovation. Nga, sabi niya, re-innovation. What you can do for the district, siling ko, I have to promote family worship. Nga aman, ang ibang sila na amazed because I know even pastors, they don't have time ang kauturan sa pag-worship with their families, no? Sorry to say this, no? May mga leaders kita sa church na bangun sa ilang kasakuon, bisan sa ilang mga responsibilidad pa, nalipatan nila ang pag-worship with their kids o po ng ilang wife. Kaya ako nagapati, Ma'am Bel, nga ining family worship na ginobra natin, this is a small group model na gusto sa Diyos nga pagahimuan natin, that ang small group, hindi anay magkato dito sa church kung wala nag-start diri sa family. How could we do some small groups, ang care group sa aton nga church, kung mismo sa atong family may mga lapses kita. And so that's why, Ma'am Bel, ako nagapatigid, prayer can do something. This can save actually sa aton nga marriage. And damo-damo sa pag-asawahay nga nagkalaguba because they do not have time to worship God. They do not have time to pray together. Okay.
Gabi, even there are marriages 27 years. Look at Bill Gates. Magulang sa mga divorce, 27 years of marital enjoyment nilang yung marital status and nag-break lang. And 30, may ibang din 30 years, di ba? 20 years. Naman, it's because wala na to na safeguard ang aton marriage sa tuod-tuod nga foundation, which is prayer.
Supposedly.
Importante katama, gid man gani. So, check to ni mga kauturan. If we want to have a marriage in God's way, we must first built it on the foundation, the correct and the right foundation, which is Jesus Christ. Prayer,
ganyan.
If daw hindi na ako mag-intindihan na, pray about it. If there are kids, may mga kabataan ka, mga rebellious, pray about it. Lubihi. Kung daw hindi na natin makontrol at mga kabataan, pray. If nagduda kasi mong bana ka daw, may ginahimo ngayon, pray. Iampo, ganyan siya. Di ba, Pastor? And
yes,
the Lord can do great wonders. Nga, hindi mo ma-imagine nga, kaya niya mahimo. Beyond their imagination.
Kaisa nangabot ang time nga, daw, ang re-cage sa relationship, daw almost na mag-abot sa muna. prayer can save it. Mga pinalangga na ito ng mga kauturan because ang hindi mahimo sa tao, mahimo sa Diyos para sa ito.
Ang bagay ni Scott Lapierre, one thing I have learned after 13 years of marriage is that prayer is not the last resort.
Usually, amo nang ilang na mambele.
Kanda wala na, on the brink of breakup na,
prayer na yun.
Pray na ta. Diba, but ang balik, Scott, marriage, prayer in marriage is not the last resort. In fact, it is the first line of defense against any attack. This is especially true in regards to marriage.
Amo na nga ba nila, ma'am, nga 1 Thessalonians 5:17, anong siling niya? Pray without ceasing. Nga, amang yung gintudlo, ina sa ato makautoran sa Ginoo ang model nga magpangamuyo sing wala sang unta, to kung magpangamuyo sing wala sing langan. Kaya ang yawa, by any, every time, nagpangabudlay, gid siya nga maguba ang aton nga family, obdanay ka musubong, lugay, lugay, magtalikod, something will happen. Because ang gusto gid siya sang yawa, nga mag-intervenar gid siya, nga kung mahimo, mawasak kag maguba niya ang isa ka panimalay.
Because when Satan can destroy our small family, ikamay lang na, ato na napanimalay. If God can destroy our marriage and eventually our family, He can destroy almost everything. Grabe ang yawa, subong. If Satan doubles his effort, we shall triple ours. Grabe ang challenge sa aton. And you see, Pastor, nagkabata ang kasunod sa marriage. That means nagka-immature ang nagkasunod sa marriage. Thus, they are creating marriage na hindi ready. Marriage na hindi well-founded. So, they also create generations na hindi man ready. Na generations nga broken man. So, grabe ang yawak mga kauturan. Manahan ba ko, if Satan doubles his efforts, let us triple ours through prayer. Okay, pang-tatlo, learn and practice effective communication skills. Hambal pa gan isang-isa ka anonymous author, hambal niya. If two people love each other, love and successful marriage will just happen. It will be natural. Oh, hambal ba ni Scott? It's a myth. It's a myth. Because there is nothing natural about good communication. Having satisfying marriage where love flourishes and there's growing closeness and friendship is not something we're just born to be naturally. We are not born naturally to communicate well. Punta namin na dito, mayad na dahil ito mag-communicate. No, on the contrary, good communication requires advanced skills. The good thing is, these skills are learnable. And the great thing is, God's Word can equip us with invaluable and advanced communication skills. Easy lang, Pastor, yung mga hambal, no, nga. Paabot sa marriage ba lang? Love is enough. Mm-hmm. Di ba? Hambal, basta may gugma lang ko, ah, sige na, go. Ha? But love, dili ba lang enough, lagi na, gugma. Pag-abot sa marriage, it's a different thing. No? So, amo ni siya na rin, hambali, here are the keys. There are all, hambali ni Scott, there are 5 keys to marriage, to good, well communication ka, no? There are 5 keys. The first key, Pastor, is?
Be honest. But speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up into all aspects unto Him, who is the head, even Christ. Therefore, laying aside falsehood, speak truth, each one of you with his neighbor, for we are members of one another, according to Ephesians chapter 4, verses 15-25. Mambel, speaking about sa ginatawag natong language, bala Mambel, atong kain na balik-balik kita gamay, ito kain sa atong nga slide, you know, communication skills, no? Daw, gusto ko maghatag gamay sini. Lain ang imo nga pag-grow, lain ang akong pag-grow, lain ang lingwahe nga natunan mo sa panimalay, lain man ang lingwahe nga natunan ko. In fact, ako karaya, ikaw si Buwana, we have different cultures. Pero Mambel, anong ginimo sa Ginoo? Ihimo niya kita nga daw imbudo, nga imbudo. Dako kita, nagkalain-lain kita ng mga lifestyle, nagkalain-lain kita ng culture. Tapos, in the end, isahon niya kita sa diin. Bible, through His Word. Good to know, yung ang Biblia ginatag niya sa aton, and this is it. Ang isa sa magintudlo sa marat niya kasulatan sa atin, Ephesians chapter 4:15 and verse 25 is that we have to practice honesty. Mabata nila, nga man honesty, because honesty is the best policy. But not only best policy, honesty, nga ba niya, will lead us sa pagbiya naton sa ano, number one, falsehood. Hindi kita maging butigon. Then, we can, what? We can speak truth. Makaistorya kita. Hindi lang ba sa pagbinutig, Ma'am Bel? Mm-hmm. Amo nang ba sa Book of James nga, may mga butang nga maayo, pero wala mo ginhimo, mm-hmm. sa lagyapon siya. Doon nga, Ma'am Bel, kita nga, abinaton kong kaisa, ang sala lang, gin, amo itong paghimo sa sala. Pero may mga maayo, galing, nga nahimo siya nga sala, kay maayo na wala mo ginhimo. And that is the practice of speaking what is true. Each one of you, no, ba niya, is one, each one of you, with his neighbors, for we are members of one another. Okay?
The next key to good communication skills in marriage, aside from being honest, is to deal with anger without sinning.
Anger management, uh-huh. Mabel, very kwan ginino.
Amo daw nagaka-block eye ng mga wife. Mm-hmm. Mga wife, kaya nga man.
Pero ang bagay nila, Mabel, sorry, gino, daw nga ti, hindi man ginini mangin matuod. Pero ang bagay nila, yung maayo pa ng black eye, ganit kung kaisa ko, no, kay maayo pa dali. Pero ang sakit sa tagipusoon, kung nakambal ka, bangot akig ka, puwerti ka budlay dulaon. Mm-hmm. And why is it? Habang sa Ephesians chapter 4, verse 26, be angry and do not sin. No? Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Mamangkot kita kung kaisa, paano ikaw makapangakig, pero hindi ikaw magpakasala? Arang explanation. The principle is, deal with anger appropriately. Be angry, but not sin. No, we have this tendency, Ma'am Bel, na magpangakig, no, human as we are, may aragin ba chance sa mga kauturan niya, kung kaisa makabati kita sa istorya, kung kaisa mahabuyan kita, sakit-sakit ba yan ang mga tinaga sa aton yung mga partners, we have this tendency, ang kaldiro, galupad, Ma'am Bel, no, ang kalaha, no, ang plato, ang baso natin, yung kalabuka, wala man gasabat, Ma'am Bel, wala man nagasabat sa ginahambal sa aton na spouse, pero sa action, makikita natin na naakig na siya. That's what we call mga kauturan nga, ang issue there is more about sa ginatawag natin to deal with anger appropriately.
Wala okay? Kayo may nasakitan.
Why kasing nasakitan? Uh-huh. Yes, it's true nga kita nagakaakig man, but we have to think, uh-huh. ano ba yun ang ma-produce niya? Kaya ang ba nila, to be tempted is not sin.
Uh-huh.
Oh, di ba? Ano no? To be tempted. Temptation is not a sin. But
pero
to be
tempted,
but to be tempted, amo na nga nahimo siya nga sala. So, same as with anger.
Mm-hmm.
Same as with anger. So, kung ang mga products ini, kung pasugtan lang naton, magubagid ang aton panimalay.
So, we have honesty and deal with anger. No,
dealing with anger. Okay.
Pangatlo, Pastor, key number 3 in having well or good communication.
Sila niya diri.
Slow down and watch your words. Because Ephesians 4:29 says, let no unwholesome word proceed from your mouth, mm-hmm. but only such a word as is good for edification according to the need of the moment, that it may give grace to those who hear. Ang pala na nga, sa dalaga pa, kag sa sotero pa, or kung sa bisaya pa, sa dalaga pa, kag ulitawo, nami pa kayo maghambal, no? Though hindi ka pa kabuka, nami pagid. Pero when it comes to marriage, sakit na kisa ito mga hambal. No, which is, that's right. Key to a good communication, having good communication skills in marriage is, slow down. Watch your words. Connected gapon siya sa
anger management.
Oo. Watch your words. Ano kung tagid ang ato nga baba? Kung wala man ang tasing mga mahambal nga iban, iinom ka na lang tubig.
Very tempting, Abi Mambel, kung kaisang magwakal kita sa mga butang na wala sing pulos. So, amunang ginambalgan ni Paul nga siling niya, likawantay ni bisan sa Ellen White, nagisiling foolish talking, jesting, and joking. Mm-hmm. Mga butang dalakon kaisa, nga doon nga tingin gusto natin doon pang good time lang, and somebody welcome, we had to share words sometimes, but you know, kung nakita natin makauturan nga hindi man lang maayo, it cannot profit sang somebody nga gusto natin sugiran, better stop. Better stop because hindi na yung will sa Diyos sa ito. Ang key number 4, Ma'am Bel, is keep your relationship clear
of debris.
When we speak debris, Ma'am Bel, is
falling objects.
Not falling objects, yeah.
Meaning sina Pastoria, mm-hmm. we should be kind.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. We should be kind to our spouse. No, tender-hearted. Just as God in Christ has also forgiven you. Mm-hmm. It means, hindi tapagtagaan sang chance ang yawa nga ma-control ta in a way nga may mahimo kita nga mga butang
mm-hmm.
nga at the end hinulsulan
natin.
Oo. Let's keep your relationship clear. Mm-hmm. And the last one, mga kautor, is listen with your heart, not just your head.
Ephesians 4:29. Nga man mambel. Okay, explain you ka maing Ephesians 4:29 that they may benefit those who listen. Nga man mambel. Ngayon ka isa, you have to listen to your heart.
With your heart.
With your heart.
Not just
not just your head.
Sa kalitiran mo na...
Kaya kung kay isa abi, tuon na, no? Pero di ba ginapromote na ito nga ang heart among deceitful? But you know, sometimes makauturan, ang atong brain nagatudlo, amo nang insakto eh. And we keep on insisting it. Amo nang tama. Without any consideration, amo nang nagwa ang alambalano na, I would rather be kind than be right.
Mm-hmm.
There are tendencies makauturan, hamba ko pagani, may mga hitabo sa atong kabuhi, mga sasulod sa panimalay, no? You are right in a wrong way. Tama man tani itong imo, binimo. Insakto magin ang imo prinsipyo ba? Pero kaya ang imo nga pag-act, pag-deliberate mo, mo sa isa ka situation is harsh na naka-hurt ka na sa somebody, mo na ba nga you are right supposedly but in a wrong way. So wrong gihapon, di ba Mabel?
O daw sa babae, bala ko na aki kung na-hurt na ang imong wife sa malalaki, usually pag na-hurt na wife na ano ikaw, mabay wife, why ah? Ever actually if you would understand that gamito mo yung heart, you know there is something really wrong.
Really wrong.
O na-hurt gid siya. Oh, hindi mo lang sa imo lang mala nabatian, eh, okay man lang siya galing. But actually, she's not. Diba? So, sometimes you need to listen with your heart, not just your head.
We have to be passionate at times.
So, let's continue with number 4, humbaldi. Find out what your spouse likes and do it. Keep doing it and find out what your spouse doesn't like and quit doing it. Because what usually happens prior to marriage, couples take great care in being their best selves. The best boyfriend, the best girlfriend, they go out of their way to find out what the other person... They go out of their way to find out what the other person likes, to shower them with their heart's desires. However, they think they... But after the wedding and the honeymoon period ended, they think they no longer need to do the special things for each other. And this usually happens.
Yes.
Tanan halos nga may problema sa marriage, mahambal gid ang babae or lalaki, hindi man siya amo before. Diba? Nag-change gid siya, hindi man siya amo sini before. Diba? So sad. Okay. It's really sad. Because marriage is built on friendship. Friends, gig ka mo ya. Friendship is the bond that sustains a relationship. When the romantic fire has dwindled down, when you begin to understand your partner's likes and dislikes, passions and goals, and innermost working, it helps you to know him or her in a way that you otherwise will not. Kung friends gig ka mo, nag-start ka mo nga friends, biskan ano pa na ma-discover mo sa iya, you will understand. Kaya naman, ang inyong bonding, aside sa relationship yung sa married life, nag-start ka mo.
Kanabi lang tanawin, wala kang batsyagon mong bell nga, there are couple nga, and ang ila, the way sila nga bala mag-treat sa isa ka isa, the best friend lang gyapon, ang friendship bala nag-last, ang courtship nag-last even until sa ilang marriage. So, ang point sin is, friendship is very important when it comes, di ba madumduman natin sa una? Wadong dumanta mabel nga ang aton nga friends, there are those people nga magstay gid sa aton despite sa aton nga mga kapait, they're even willing to sacrifice their time para lang gid nga ma-connect sila sa aton, ma-lift kita lin sa aton nga mga burden, some nga mga kahintangan, and they're there willing to help us, no? Same as true sa ginatawag naton mga pinalangga naton nga makauturan sa marriage, that God wants us to make our spouse as our best friend.
That no matter how imperfect our spouse could be or might be, we are still there to accept and to embrace our spouse, no? And then the last one, mga kotoran, in connection with that, let us forgive often.
Somebody came, Pastor, ang akon nga bana nakasala. And I do not know what to do. Problema na siya sa management sa sulod sa panimalay. But what controls her, because what controls her actually is the fault, ang sala ang ginimo sa iya, bana. And so I said, actually, siling ko, for you to have peace, makaangpon ka sang kalinom, kag makapahuway ka, agud makafocus ka sa imong kabuhi, all you need is forgiveness. Sometimes, Mabel Abi, ang pinakapait nga part sa pag-asawahay is acceptance and forgiveness. Ang aton abi nga gina-expect kon ka isa ang aton mga partners, mga pinalangga naton nga mga kauturan, they are perfect in such a way nga wala gikita sa i-commentar sa ila. They are so perfect nga hindi sila magkahimo sang sala. But remember this, we are also fighting. No, nag-aaway man kita, nagapakig-away kita, batok sa tag-sa-tag sa kaluyahon. And we have to understand and to practice the meaning of what we call forgiveness. Why?
Because forgiving someone who has harmed you is the hardest part of loving, and yet you cannot continue to truly love without doing it. Manigabal na pastor niya, forgiveness. You give forgiveness, not just for the person. Actually, the benefit is not just for the person you forgive, but actually, the benefit is on you. Diba? You gain peace in forgiving someone, in forgiving your spouse, you gain peace. Diba? You gain peace. And then, you gain acceptance. And you move on. Because no matter what we do, as long as inita ka balo mag-forgive, hindi gid maging successful ang ating marriage. Hindi gid siya maging, oo. And, to end, we'd like to share this story to end about this marriage in God's way.
Okay. I just want to read the story. Kagkabay nga mahangpan ninyo. There was a very unusual military funeral in California in December of 2013. No? Sergeant First Class Joseph Gunt, who fought in World War II in the Korean War, was laid to rest. So, napatay siya. He had been captured in Korea in 1950 and died the following year. But his body was not returned for many years, and his death was never confirmed by the North Koreans. His wife, Clara, waited for decades for her husband to come back. She regularly went to meetings with government officials seeking information about what happened. Clara even bought a house and had it professionally landscaped, so all Joseph would have to do when he came home was go fishing.
So she was expecting that
makapauli pa.
Yeah, she was expecting that her husband would return home. Kaya wala man siya kakita sa remains. Wala man report nga napatay ang bana, wala gyud siya. So she was expecting that her husband would soon return and would go fishing on the new built house, diba?
But let us remember, she waited for decades already. Mm-hmm. Decades, ha? Speaking decades.
Actually, Pastor, it's 60 years.
Okay. Uh-huh. What happened next? She was 94 years old when she remained with... When his remains were finally brought home for a military funeral with full honors. Okay? It wasn't the homecoming she dreamed of. Isip mo, 94 years old siya, Mambel, naghinulat kid siya, no? Kapag abot abi, nakita niya, nahibalaan niya ang iyang abana, gali, patay. Hindi man to, amugin ang ginpaabot niya. But she finally knew his faith. Nahibalaan niya na kung din padulong ang iya abana because he's a military. Clara told a reporter who interviewed her, "He told me if anything happened to me or to him, ambalan niya ko niya, sige, nambalan niya ko sa una, yako na nung matabo man din sa iya, no? Gusto niya nga magpangasawa ako liwat, no? Kung magpamana ako liwat. Amo na, nga pamangkot. By the way, siguro ang reporter nagpalapit sa iya, so ang reporter, ginsugiran niya, niya sa buhi pang akon ba na, ginambalan niya ako, ako na nung matabo sa akon,
sa iya ba na,
niya, mamana ako liwat, no? Amo na, ambal sa iya nga ba na. Anong sabat ni Clara? And I told him, no. Nga man niya hindi, no? Here I am, still his wife, and I'm going to remain his wife until the day that the Lord calls me home.
It could be a very beautiful story. Mm-hmm. It exemplifies the real essence of marriage. Grabe, there's loyalty, there's dedication, there's commitment.
Treasure niya.
If only our spouse, or if only ang marriage bala, amo nang ginbutang nga kaimportansya sa marriage. There's loyalty, there's commitment, there's dedication. Ano kamalipayon tani ang isa ka panimalay, no? Ang isa ka marriage, ang isa ka panimalay bala, Pastor, grabe, no? If you have dedication, if you have commitment, loyalty, faithfulness. Nami-nami yung mga kotoren.
Si dinatabakit ano ang ang picture kon ano nga klase sang pag-asawahay. So 94 years old ang ara sila. Mambel,
60 years of waiting.
60 years of waiting. Oo.
But that's truly the essence of marriage.
Why, Mambel? Mm-hmm. Because nag-deposit sila
sa taas na nga interest. Kaya damo na sila gin-deposit. Uh-huh. Ah, diba?
They gain that interest because ang deposit nga, deposit. Okay. So, marriage, okay? Sige niya din, no? Isa ka question, no? Why did God choose to create Eve from Adam's side instead of creating her from dust of the ground like everything else? Pwede mo tayo moon sang ginutan niya from out from the dust.
Pwede lang ito niya nga kaginhimo man niya si Adam sa dust, himo man niya si Eve from the dust. But no, nga man. Because God wanted Adam and Eve to understand the unity between them. Men and women were designed to fit perfectly in all ways, physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually. So when a husband and wife become one flesh on their wedding day, they are two people who complement and complete each other, and together they become something stronger and more magnificent than they could ever be alone. The strengths of each other compensate for the weaknesses of the other. And that is marriage. God's way.
God is very good. Mga pinalangga natin yung mga kauturan. That He designed this marriage, no? Nga ginumpisahan niya dito sa Garden ng Eden, sa aton una nga mga ginikanan. And we have the model that when God, ang bata sa ambahan ng Mambel, when God is in the family,
happy home.
So kabay nga ang ini nga mga pagtulunan, ini mga butang nga natun-an naton sa kabuhi, mga kauturan sa mag-asawa, mga applications sang aton nga mga natun-an, makita naton if we will just apply all of this. And I know by experience, kamo tanan-tanan yung pinalangga naton nga mga kauturan na kahibalugit. Kung anong katahum ang pag-asawahay, Mambel, when God is the center of our relationship. Marriage is God's model for us, like His relationship to the church. And God wants His church to be pure. God wants His church to be noble. God wants His church to have that commitment, no? Kag mangin mahigugmaon sa iya, mangin committed sa iya, and remain faithful tubtob sa iya nga pagbalik. Same as true with our spouses.
I remember my high school teacher at SD Sign Adventist Academy in Leyte. I would always remember her, Ma'am Chak pala raw. When we were in fourth year, she would always remind us, and she would always tell us, marriage is beautiful. And now I could say that you are right, Ma'am. Marriage is beautiful when God is in the center of it. It's really a triangle relationship. The wife, the husband, and the Lord. And truly you will experience that indeed marriage is beautiful.
So madamong salamat mga kauturan sa inyong pagpakig-upod sa amon, sa pag-share, no, sang sining aton nga mga ino, mga burdens naton sa aton nga kabuhi. Kay balo ako nga kun nagabuligay lang ang mag-asawa, Mambel, when there are unities, may mga unity lang gid sa sulod sang panimalay, may mga paghangpanay lang, may paghigugma lang, may ara lang gid kita nga pagbuligay, labi na gid ang faithfulness naton sa isa kay isa kay sa aton Dios. Indeed, our family will be successful. Okay?
So thank you so much for being with us. Thank you so much for being with us throughout our program. Our prayer would always be, nga tani, when Jesus comes, all our family members, our spouses, we will all bring them together in that heavenly home the Lord has prepared for each one of us. What a great and grand day that will be. When our spouse, our family members, our children will also be there with us.
Madamong salamat sa inyong pag-upod sa amon ng Diyos. Magapakamayo sa inyong bugos nga panimalay. Iniamon nga pagpanugdaon halindiri sa pamilya ninyo, mga kauturan ninyo from West Visayan Conference. Ang Diyos magapakamayo. God bless everyone.
God bless.
When God is in the family, love is always there.
When God is in the family, we're closer together.
When God is in the family, blessings are found everywhere.
When God is in the family, everything is there. So let Him now come in, my friend. Through your door is always knocking. He brings with Him His gift for us, and the gift is life eternal. When God is in the family, love is always there. When God is in the family, we're closer together. When God is in the family, blessings are found everywhere.